In this video, we're going to talk about the language used in the discussion section. Remember, the discussion is the last section of the research paper. In the discussion, you are reviewing the results of your experiment and writing about your ideas for possible explanations and comparing these with previous research. Some of these things are facts, that is, we know that they are true, and some of these are your opinions, ideas, and suggestions. The language you use shows the readers your level of confidence with the information. You might remember that in the introduction videos we said everything you write needs proof so that we can believe you. You can use citations or a clear logical argument or the measurements from your own experiment to provide the evidence. In the discussion, you'll do these same things, but you will also use words that show that you recognize that some of the things you say can't be proven. In fact, you will often discuss opposite possibilities, so there can't be proof. But the reader needs to understand clearly what you know and what is just your suggestion. The discussion section often uses these two tenses, and in a similar way to the introduction and results section. Present tense is generally used when reporting the findings of the research, but past tense is used for the details of the experiment. You can think of this like this. The showing is happening right now in the paper, but the underestimating occurred when they actually did the experiment. In this example, past tense is used when talking about what someone else did in their paper. These guys suggested this. But present tense is used for the general result of their study, which is a truth now. Arousing music reduces the attentional space available, and so on. Next, when we write our opinions or ideas or other things that we can't be 100% certain are true, we use hedging to make our confidence level clear. Now, the first sentence here uses the word proved, which implies that this is 100% true and accepted. And the second sentence uses suggested instead to show that this has not been accepted as 100% true. Here are some techniques we can use for hedging. We can use words like may, might, and could. Words like suggest, words like possibly or probably, or it is likely that, it is possible that, and also words like seem to show, appear to show, tend to show, to make the show even weaker. Okay, let's look for some examples of this in the paper about music and the behavior of gorillas. Okay, so here's the discussion section. The findings from this study suggest that captive gorillas, like humans and other primates, may be influenced by their auditory environment. Okay, so you remember from here that they had no significant results. So they can't say shows, they can only say suggests or may be influenced. Okay, now these are the facts of their study. There was no evidence of a statistically significant effect. Okay. Nonetheless, there was a pronounced trend, okay, for the animals to spend more time displaying behaviors indicative of relaxation. Okay. There definitely was a trend, a pronounced trend, but not a statistically significant trend. Okay. This is the paragraph where they discuss surprising results. The ecologically non-relevant sounds, classical music, appeared slightly more beneficial. Okay, and we're using appeared because, again, we don't actually know that it was beneficial. We just have some evidence to point toward that. Okay, and then here's some backup for that. Over 50% less aggression, 30% less abnormal behavior was noted. Again, this is a fact. Okay, previous research, this is previous research. Research suggests that classical music may have a beneficial effect. Okay, and they have some citations here, but again, this is still an issue. This is still a topic that's open to debate. Quite surprisingly, the gorillas in this investigation reacted. Well, they did react, that's true. Interestingly, Ogden et al., these guys found that two zoo house gorillas, okay, and we're using past tense here to talk about these guys' research. Now down here, we're talking about the mechanism behind auditory stimulation affecting these gorillas, okay? And they use this kind of phrase here. It is possible that it simply serves as a mask, buffering the animals from the noise of visitors. Okay. Alternatively, it may be the case that there is something specific and enriching about certain types. Okay. And for instance, while it's not conclusive, there is some evidence. Well, here we go. This is not using may or might, but there is some evidence that Mozart's sonata may promote cognitive functioning in humans and animals. Classical music encouraged slightly less aggression. And then we get down here to our further work is needed to unravel the specific acoustic elements that animals respond to. Okay, and again in our final paragraph, overall this study suggests that captive gorillas are slightly, though not significantly, influenced by their auditory environment. And there we go, further research is needed to determine the long-term effects. Okay. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Remember, if you want more examples of hedging or using these tenses, look at actual research papers and look at the discussion sections. That's the best way to learn.